Okay, so today we're going to be learning how to use Chunky, which came out quite a while ago, but is still quite a problem for some people to use. Pretty much, it's quite simple, but we're just gonna learn how to use many of the different controls and effects you can produce. So first you wanna do is you wanna open up your world. Any world, really. Just give it a moment here. Put up my city world here. I think this is the one. Yeah. So I'm gonna turn down my render distance here. And I'm going to position myself so that I'm facing wherever I want the render to be facing. Sorry, it's lagging here because I'm recording and I just opened up the world. So, because Chunky is only in 1.1, I'm going to have to be facing somewhere that doesn't include any post 1.1 blocks. So, I'll just position myself right about here, maybe. I'll go for right here, and I'm going to exit. You don't have to do anything after that, just point yourself in that direction, and that's where your render will be facing. And now you're going to open up Chunky. Select the world. So, the world I'm in. Then you're going to shift, click, and drag around the chunks that you want to be rendered. So, because I'm facing this way, I don't need the chunks behind me. I'm just going to render about to this building. So that's about maybe 40 chunks or 30 chunks. And you're gonna right click it, or what you can do is you can hit 3D render in this list of tabs here. If you want to choose a different texture pack, go to options and go down to load texture pack, and I might just choose modern HD. And it'll reload and you'll see the colors have changed a bit, just like the Minecraft maps do. Again, shift click the area. I shouldn't have done that before, but it doesn't matter. And right click it or hit 3D render and new scene. So I'm just gonna right click it. And I'm gonna name it Chunky. And hit OK. These two windows will pop up, render controls dash chunky and render preview. This is just showing you kind of a preview of what your render will look like, but less realistic, obviously. So in this general area, it'll have scene name. That'll be the name that it saves your scene as in the directory, and you can open your scene directory just to check where all your scenes are being saved to. I don't think you can change this directory. It's set so that that's where it's always gonna save. You can save your scene if you want to render it later on. You can load a scene that you've already saved. You can change your canvas width and canvas height, which is this right here, and the size of the render that'll come out of it. So I'm just going to change it to 950 by 550. Not too big, but at the same time, it's fine enough. You can halve it and you can double it, and you can make this your default so that when you open up this, no matter what, it'll always start off as 950 by 550. So you can change enable gamma correction, which is so that it corrects your gamma and you are no longer with excessive amounts of gamma or anything. You can choose still water, which is no ripples or waves, which I don't want to choose, but doesn't really matter. Oh, actually, I'm gonna change this texture pack. So what I'm gonna do is I want to make this my default so I don't have to change it back when I reach when I change my texture pack again. So I'm just gonna change this texture pack to EliteCraft HD, which I'll put up a download link so you guys can check it out as well. So I'll just reselect the chunks, shift click and drag, right click it, rename it, and all this stuff will get easier later on. So what I want to do now, so that I was in the area that I was facing in the game, is go to camera and hit camera to player. And that'll set it so that the camera view is where the player was. So back to general. That's pretty much all you can do with general. Lighting. Enable emitters. That's obviously glowstone, torches, redstone torches, anything that emits light, any blocks that you can place in the game that emit light, those are what they're talking about. So you can change the intensity. So intensity all the way down is 0, and it's pretty much the same as not enabling emitters, which you can do, but I don't recommend because it doesn't look too great. And I'm just going to bring this up so the city looks a little brighter. Enable sunlight. That pretty much disables or enables sunlight from hitting anything, which is pretty self-explanatory. Sun intensity, that's the intensity, obviously. Sun yaw is its rotation. And sun pitch is how low it is in the sky. So I'm just going to make it about 4 p.m., 5 p.m., and rotate it so it's right over there. Because I like to have the equal amount of shadows to sunlight. You can change your sun color, but I won't do that because it really makes no sense and it looks ridiculous. So, as you can see, blue sun makes everything blue. That's usually only used if you're, I don't know, retarded. But anyways, we're just going to change it back to what it was. Wait, hold on. Yeah, back to what it was. Sorry. You can load a sky map, which pretty much is clouds or stars or whatever. I'm not going to use a sky map because I don't have that many. They're pretty hard to find. But I'll put up some links in the description about where you can find them because they're pretty rare. So when you're choosing a sky map, you want a sky map that's a higher resolution, but not too high to where it's just completely grainy, because you want the sky to look nice and realistic, but I'm not going to do that for now. You can enable atmosphere, which is pretty much making it look a little more realistic by adding a sort of a fog, but kind of a mist to the area. So I'm just going to show you guys what that looks like with and without later on. You can rotate your sky map and you can unload it in case you don't really want it and you want to choose a different one. So let's say I choose, I don't know, yeah, let's say I choose anything really and I don't want it. I can reload it as a different sky map. You can enable volumetric fog, which I don't really know what it is, but I do not recommend it at all because it makes objects far away look pretty horrible. It pretty much just adds a gradient so that it looks a little foggier, but they haven't updated it in a long time, so it doesn't look too great. Camera. You can center the camera, which is pretty much I have no idea. That pretty much just brings your camera up, I guess, to the center of the chunks. Oh yeah, that's what it is. To the center of the chunks, and it aims it straight forward, which I wouldn't recommend because you don't really want to be looking directly at the sky, which is kind of stupid. In the camera section, you also have field of view, which is your zoom. You can zoom all the way out, or you can zoom all the way in. It's pretty far zoom. Only cool if you want sort of a zoomed in effect. But I'm going to keep it at 70 because I just want it to look like you're like a normal day, like you're just walking along and you see this. So you can change it by typing in the number, and you can change it by dragging it. So I'm just gonna leave it at 70. And you can change your depth of field, which is basically closer blocks. You can change how close blocks must be in order to not be blurred. If it's at infinite, that means all blocks are as clear as they can be. So it's pretty much just adding a deep feel to it, and it's pretty much just for aesthetics. But I'm gonna keep it at infinite, just so I can see the whole area and it's not gonna be blurred completely. Focal offset is, I guess that's sort of, I have no idea. But autofocus sort of resets everything, so your depth of field, so that you can see everything completely, and it autofocuses it for you. You can hide your preview, but definitely never do that because you want to see what you're doing. Advanced ray depth. That's pretty much how deep the rays of light and sunlight are. Gamma is obviously kind of your exposure, but pretty much how bright your colors are. It's not really contrast, just how vivid your colors are. Water world module, or mode, sorry. I think it just surrounds your area with water. Yeah, you can change the height of the water, but I don't see why you want to do that. So what we're going to do here, you can save dump every 500th frame, every 50th, 100th, 1000th frame, but I like to keep it at 500 in case I accidentally forget that it's open in another window and I shut down my computer, so at least I'll have some version of it on my computer. Because you'll notice that it takes quite a while to render these things if you want a good render, which is kind of a downside, but it's the best, in my opinion, is the best shader slash aesthetic modification to Minecraft, because the rest of the in-game shaders, they aren't as, their quality isn't as great, but that's just my opinion. SPP target, lastly, is pretty much, I'm not sure exactly what it stands for, if somebody can throw that in the comments, but it's pretty much how grainy or how non-grainy you want your render to be. 1000 is, it's pretty clear, but you will still see some grains if you're angling your camera differently. 2000 is pretty much clear, and taking it beyond 5000 is just overkill, because you don't need anything more than that. You won't even be able to see any greens. And once you bring it up to 6000, it pretty much just smoothens out a lot of textures, and it doesn't look too great. So I'm just going to leave it at 1250, because I'm not sure, but it leaves it at not too many greens, but still clear enough. So what we're going to do is just hit start, and it does take quite a while, so I'm just going to skip past the render, and I'll see you guys back soon. But first, let me just change the sun so it's higher in the sky, so I can see a little bit more shadows. So it's maybe a little farther behind, so it hits the side of the building like that. So I'll hit start, and I'll see you guys in maybe 45 minutes. And as you can see, it starts rendering. So, see you guys back here in 45 minutes. Play some music. This is reggae music. Root rock reggae. This is reggae music. Okay, so as you can see, the render has finished. It will say saving render dump, however many dumps there are of the same number, and it'll say ETA, estimated time approximately, NA. And as you can see, our render is finished, finally. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. There really is nothing else to it. Just make sure your sunlight is correct, make sure your lighting is right, and make sure you take a look at your render before you do it. I'd recommend setting up your lighting and your sun hitting start just and first for the first 5 seconds. Just let it run for 5 seconds or so and see how it looks. Because if you just move to a different window and you look back and it's finally done after an hour, or 2 hours maybe, 3 hours even, depending on how big the render is, you don't want to mess up and you don't want to regret not changing it while you could. So always take a look at it before you hit render and you go away from it. A downside to this is that if you want to use your computer while it's rendering, for a lot of laptops and lower end computers such as mine, your performance will be greatly decreased, mainly because it takes up a lot of memory and a lot of RAM to render this. I'm not entirely sure, but yeah, it doesn't work too well on lower end computers and most laptops unless you have a high end laptop. But they all save to a certain directory. If you want to access that directory from where they save to, hit open scene directory in your general tab and you'll see all of your renders. Some of these will be dot backup. Most of these will be dot octree, dot backup, or dot dump. Some of them will be dot cvf, dot backup. But if you want all of your renders, only the images, to go to a certain folder, you're gonna have to do that manually, because as far as I'm concerned, you can't change your directory to where they save. But you can just control click all of them or shift click all of them and copy and paste or click and drag to wherever you want them saved to. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Make sure you preview it thoroughly before you hit render, because like I said, it takes a long time and you don't want to regret wasting that time. So thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Heard it's 2,000 a bottle, waitress, can I get a